Hey, good afternoon, everybody. It's after half an hour, it's time for lunch. So like this is my last talk before the lunch. So I'm going to present here about delivering a bleeding edge community late OpenStack distribution that is known as RDO. So from last two talks, you came to know what is OpenStack. So OpenStack is a collection of open source services through which you can form public and private cloud. About me, C has already introduced me. Moving ahead, let's talk about RDO. What is RDO? So RDO, there is no actual full form. You can call it anything. Somebody calls it as a RPM-based distribution of OpenStack. It's a group of people who rapidly deploy OpenStacks. And if your name starts with R, it's your R Richard distribution of OpenStack. And currently, it has more than 350 packages maintained and still growing. When I say about packages, it means OpenStack packages. So since RDO is an RPM-based distribution of OpenStack, let's understand what is RPM package. So when you used Red Hat-based distribution, Fedora, CentOS, or RHEL, when you do RPM-Q, Python, you get something like name, version, release. So name is the name of the project, version refers to the version of the project, and release is related to the spec file, and .rpms is another file format. RPMs comes from SRPM, which contains source plus spec file. And when you call about the source is the actually upstream source code of the project. And within a package, there are a list of included files which got installed at particular places when you install a package. And what is actually within a spec file? Spec file is another file format which has configuration file format which contains some steps for how to build a package, installation and removal procedures, what are the dependencies of a package if you want to introduce any patch with the package that it contains. The people who do packaging are known as packager. We also call them spec file developers. So before going to the job of spec file developers, what a packager needs? They need a diskit server. So diskit server is nothing different from a source code repository server that is created from GitLite or from your GitLab or GitHub or your own deployment Git server. A diskit server, we generally keep all the spec files, so that's why I call it diskit server. For packaging, we need a peer-to-peer review. When I say about peer-to-peer review, multiple people should review the spec file. They have a better understanding of the projects itself. There should be an automated testing and validation of all the spec file in isolated environment. It does not have an internet connection. It should not down anything from outside world. Otherwise, it will start downloading. So if you try to install it somewhere, it will start break. Smart merge management. When I say what smart management, makes your you revise sync your packages at multiple branches, and it should work fine. The packages are also responsible for writing systemd unit files, so that when you are packaging a service, make sure after installation it starts, stopped, enabled, and disabled. And you have to make sure in the spec file that your after installation your particular files, configuration files, and executable goes at particular presses. You have to follow the upstream changes also. So when say new versions of a project comes up, make sure you update the package automatically or through manually. If there is some vulnerabilities comes up, you have to patch your package and ship as soon as possible. Next comes to the packaging OpenStack. So you have seen the first talk from the Matt. He was saying he tried installing OpenStack from source, but it was hard and it had some problems. Like while installing, managing configuration files, propping the files at particular process. When he was, he has itself written the systemd unit files. The packaging take care of all these stuffs. So this is the So in the 1st March or 28th February, we have released a new version of OpenStack that is known as Queens. And this is the current state of project. It has more than 700 plus projects. If you check the Git repository, it has more than 1800 plus. And each release, we have more than 1600 contributors. On each day, 250 commits merge in different Git repository. And we release it every 6 months. It's a pretty fast. So there are some extra constraints for the RDO packages. They are packages, but they are special packages. They need to validate each of the spec file on a new commit merge in a project. Second, strong dependency management between packages. Suppose you have two packages, there might be a possibility they a dependency having particular version in project used in project A might be a higher version will be required in project B. So you have to take care of the managing that things also. Test systems is properly test and validate that package. We just not only to install the package and uninstall, we also need to make sure that the executables and anything which we are shipping with the package version of a project works fine. And package upgrade should work smoothly. So you have created a package. If a new release comes up, a new release of a distribution comes up, you are trying to release a package from lower version to upper version, but things are breaking. We need to take care of that also. Make sure a RDO packages works fine on three platforms, Fedora, RHEL, and CentOS. It's a pretty hard job. So these are the current states of RDO release. I have taken the four last releases. So Newton released in. So we tried to release RDO on the same day as OpenStack got released. So if you check the in Newton, we have released in 1 day. In Okata, we have released in 12 hours. In Pi, we have released in 2 days because some infrastructure issues and production push failures, and Queens made it back on track in 7 hours. How we made it possible? We are going to talk about that. So first thing what we have done is we have built a RPM factory from software factory and some RDO written tools and the community tools. We have started changing the trunk. When I say about the changing the trunk, we have started trying to test each of the commits getting merged in each of the OpenStack projects. We have different levels of CIs who are consuming RDO packages. Those are Puppet CI, Tripleo CIs, and Kolla CI, and as well as the Packstack one, where we test all the package changes. And we have more scenario jobs in our pipeline so that we promote the packages from one YAML repos to another repo. I will be explaining that in later slides. And we try to catch the issues from once a commit is merged and when we start building the packages. And we always try to improve our production change workflow. So when we're talking about the community tools, these are the community tools we use. First thing, we use Koji. So Koji is nothing. Koji is a software collection to build and store RPM package in an isolated environment. And the Koji runs on a platform known as CBS. The URL is centosbuildsystem.centoscbs.centos.org. And this all the infra is maintained by cloud SIG. So in CentOS project ecosystem, there are different kinds of SIG to maintain different kinds of projects. And we have another CI server also, which is provided by CentOS, that is ci.centos.org, which is based on Jenkins. And another, we run all the infrastructure on RDO cloud, which is using RDO Okata release. It's a production grade OpenStack deployment in-house within Red Hat. So each of the OpenStack developer has got some quota from the RDO cloud, and they try to develop OpenStack on the OpenStack itself. Let's come to the RDO tools. So first tool is DeLorean. So DeLorean is the continuous package delivery platform. So once your commits merge, DeLorean will pull that commit, and it has some information coming from the RDO info, which contains all the metadata information about a package. So once a commit got merged, DeLorean will receive it, and it also receives the spec file from the Diskit server based on the RDO informations, and will start building that package from that commit. So everything will work fine. It will be promoted to a current, and current against current we run some CIs, and after that we promote it to consistence, and with consistence repos we pass it to the pack stack CI. If everything's passed, we make a new YAM ROPO that is known as current pass CI, which is passed to the upstream CI. So suppose we are building a package, and suppose a new commit got merged, and Delivery was trying to build a package, and if anything's got break, then that commit is not promoted to current or consistent. It will again come back to the new commit. We have to fix that commit, then we proceed. So once the Delivery and packaging build process failed, we have automated scripts which will create a dummy review with the logs and with the commit mass, with the commit URL, with saying that this review is generated because of this, and this are the things causing build failures. So a maintainer got notified and fix it, and we again come back on track. We have some few more tools. So another is RDO PKZ, RDO info, config, and graffiti. So packages has to do a lot of manual steps. So suppose a new release comes up, their dependencies got updated. So currently lots of people do manually updating the dependencies and their versions. You can do it automatically by RDO PKG. So lots of manual tasks for a packages were automated by RDO PKG. Another thing is graffiti. So we also build packages for the stable branches for all the OpenStack projects. So there, once a new version comes up, it get automatically updated. Or if you are proposing a new change to the stable branches, there you need to just take care of the spec file. There it get reviewed. So once it going to get merged, there graffiti will communicate with the CBS and do a automatically tag build. And if you submit a review on the stable branch, it will do a scratch build on that and making sure it works fine. Another thing is config. So we treat all the permissions, jobs configuration, and everything as a code, and we keep it version. So suppose I have to update the configuration or I have to update the permissions, we will update it through the git configs. So we have a config repository where we manage all the configuration files, even creation of a repository through git. We have another tool that is known as Beardo. It's an Ansible based framework which takes out the gate jobs which runs under the OpenStack infrastructure and try to replicate the same thing within RDO infrastructures through Ansible playbooks. The main goal of this tool is to improve the test coverage. So for the developer, if everything works in DevStack, it's fine, but for an end user, it needs to be make sure it works on other distributions also. Beardo solves that problem. What it does, it provisions a test environment, set up the trunk repositories. When I say about the trunk, the latest repositories, then install the project and its dependencies. Suppose it's a Puppet project, then it will go through the JM file, install the specific Ruby packages and everything. Then we'll start deploying and configuring on OpenStack. And after that, once everything is configured, then it runs Tempest test, and then it uploads the logs and the results at particular server, and then it deletes the node. So in this process, if anything's got failed, you have to look it and make sure you have to fix it upstream again, then whole process will return back. Another thing is ARA, Ansible Run Analysis. So most of the projects are moving towards Ansible. So how many of you know about Ansible? Okay. So Ansible is another config management tool. So most of the projects are using Ansible to configure and deploy projects. But if you want to analyze the Ansible playbooks, you can use ARA. So you can install it from the laptop, you can try it and visualize it. So in all the OpenStack projects, we use Ansible a lot while running the jobs. So there we have to analyze how the jobs configurations looks like and how the playbooks runs and what other things happens. So this should be appear something like this. Something like this. So this one is from one of my job from upstream. What are the files related with that playbooks? You can see that. What are the tasks associated with? What are failed with this status and what happened, everything. Coming back to the track. So you can, it's a simple Python project. If you want, you can contribute to it. Another thing is Software Factory. Software Factory is a CI/CD platform based on OpenStack Upstream CI. So Upstream CI has written lots of tools to run all the jobs, test each of the packages on the dev stack, as well as provide resources to Tripleo and other installers to test their changes so that they can gracefully release a robust OpenStack. So like OpenStack has written zuul, nodepool, they have gerrit, they also contribute to gerrit, and there are lots of other projects. So currently code in Software Factory, we have packaged all the stuff so that an end user can easily deploy it in-house, a complete CI/CD platform. So one is gerrit, another is JavaScript orchestration system that is known as zuul, another is Jenkins. So they have written a replacement of Jenkins that is known as zuul. Version 3 is quite cool and awesome. So in version 3, zuul v3, you have to just define a .zuul.yaml file within your project. There you have to write your job definition. With each definition, you have to write your own scripts or Ansible playbooks. And all the jobs configurations are run and invoked by the nodepool. So nodepool, what it does, it's actually a job executor which manages slaves or servers for you. And based on the configuration defined in the zuul.yaml, it will read that, and from the zuul servers, it gets it and run on that systems. Zuul has also smart gating systems. So it makes your, suppose you have submitted a change and it depends on another change, it will make sure that your dependent change should merge first, then your change will merge. You can't merge both the things at the same place. But this is handled by zuul very nicely. And here we also treat all the configuration of Software Factory as a config. It has flexible workflow for reviewing the things through gerrit as well as a dashboards. It also provides Etherpad, Pestwin, Refer Explorer, and much more. And you can also visualize the whole events of the Software Factory through Kibana dashboards. So currently the Software Factory looks like this. Just a minute. So this is the deployed instance. It's a free software. You can download it and you can install it at your system also. Coming ahead. So we have combined all these tools and we have made a RPM factory, which is based on actually on Software Factory. And the RPM factory currently looks like this. So you can find these are the spec changes, like so delivery owner trying to build something, but it got failed. So it had created an empty dummy review. So here you can see that this is because of this commit got failed, and here are the logs of the build failure. So the maintainers associated with that project got notified, he will come ahead and fix it. Okay. And this complete review.rdo project.org that is known as RPM factory is branded for RDO. We host all the disk kit as well as the patches branches there. All the upstream changes are acted by Delorean, so each and every commits got a package build and these are properly tested. All the disk kit changes be reviewed through gerrit. So each of the code has to get 1 plus 2 and workflow plus 1, then it will get merged just like upstream. Now currently new builds are tagged automatically using Graffiti. And currently, we have lots of bots to update the versions of a package, we always try to promote the dependencies, making sure that it works properly with the installers. So like suppose we have 5 new versions of a package comes up, we will build in the CVS, tag it, and we will try to promote it to through a particular repo and make sure the all the updated versions works fine. If it will not works, we will try to downgrade it through the RDO info. So this is the current workflow which is happening. So once a upstream commits gate merge, Delorean will pick it. Delorean will create a YUM repo out of it, which is served on trunk.rdoproject.org. For the stable branches, it will create the scratch build, then the tag build, then it will promote through CentOS build system. So all the packages which gates on the builds on the CentOS build system get tagged it, and it's mirrored through different CentOS mirror servers. Then it get promoted through the current consistent currently pass CI, and they again fade it to different CIs, so that we make sure each and every YUM repo is got tested. So currently we are serving all the commits on trunk.rdoproject.org, like here.
Just a minute.
So here we serve, like you can see that, like if I check the master one. So here all the packages built from which commit, like if you check that commit got merged recently for that project. Again, this once this gets promoted, it is consumed by installer so that they can test it easily. So once we release queens, the installer can make themselves ready for this release, and they can properly release their softwares. And we try to test each and every stacks in different fashions, trying to deploy different scenario jobs. So where sometimes we are deploying OpenStack in a single node, somewhere in multiple nodes with multiple configurations. Or we are also testing the gate jobs out of the gate by using Vordo, and it also leads to delivering a more robust crowd through RDO. This is the current stats for Okata. So we have made 919 commits, 86 contributors, and we tried to release within 12 hours. And we have caught 230 build failures. This is the RDO stats from Pike release, and it got delayed because some of guys has taken PTOs. So there, for Queen's release, we decided we need to take the PDOs clearly. And we have appointed some few release wrangler for that. We have enabled more automations, and we have improved our pipeline. This is the coming stats from the Queen's. So we have 22 new contributors. We are back on track. And currently, we have implemented few things, like you can automatically update the versions. We are currently testing each and every changes on 2 platforms, Fedora and CentOS. And we used to test RDO clouds on each milestone release. So people were completing, they have no hardware. So we have introduced test cloud for that. So there you have, in the Etherpad, you have to give email IDs, and from there you will get the SSH key and start deploying that. There are a few upcoming challenges we have to pass through that. In the upcoming release, that is moving to zuul v3, another is Python 3 support. And these are the companies uses RDO from the community itself. So how to become a part of RDO community? Simple is to contribute to RDO. If you contribute to RDO, it also leads to contributing to OpenStack. Because if a DeLorean catches build failure, sometimes it happens that code has done some messy things, so you have to fix it there. There are some easy fixes also. So if you are new to OpenStack or RDO, you can check that out. We have each Wednesday weekly meetings. There you can join and attend, talk with people. And you can take one of the challenges and help it to improve. We also need documentation writers who can help in improving RDO docs. You can also improve the installers also by taking a baby steps. You can join the RDO mailing list. That's it from my side. Any questions?
Thank you, Chandan. Any questions?
Yeah.
Okay, thank you for your presentation. I'm OpenStacker, so now I'm contributing to the various nodes of OpenStacker or.
Sorry? You contribute to?
I see that IO have reviewed those IO, and we have another side review those OpenStack nodes.
Oh, yeah.
And the road sites run parallel or independent?
Yeah. So review.openstack.org runs on OpenStack provided clouds. So like currently 9 or 10 different companies had donated our clouds to them. So they are using their resources to run review.openstack.org. And RDO is running on RDO cloud, and which is based on RDO Okata release. We are soon upgrading to Quinns. And all the, but we are using the same software there and here. So in Software Factory, we have packaged all the stuffs in a single thing. So suppose if you want to deploy a CI/CD platform, just like OpenStack Infra has, so you can use the Software Factory. It will configure the gerrit for you. It will create a Git server for you. It has the pastebin, everything. You can even integrate the Storyboard, Taiga, or there is another task tracking system known as Mumble. They have also some cool thing that is known as Repo Explorer, through which you can visualize the contributions of all the people, how many commits are made, shiny heat maps and everything. They recently they have also introduced the code search, through which you, so all the Git repository associated with on that server CI/CD platform, you can visualize that and search it.
Okay. Now imagine that I have a commit to the review OpenStack. So is the commit moves to the IO?
No, so once a commit gets merged, then DeLorean will pick it.
Yeah.
And so DeLorean works on RDO info. So RDO info has all the information. So for a particular project, what is the source code repository and what is the spec file repository? So DeLorean works on hooks. So once a new commit is merged, it will trigger a hook which is listen with DeLorean.
Yeah.
Then it will face that commit and it will face the spec file. Then it will create a tarball. And after that, you will generate the RPM packages out of it. And after that, it uses mock and chroot, changes the directory. In that directory, it installed all the packages required for building the packages. And then it installs and try to upgrade it. If everything works fine, then that review is successful or the gentle will give plus one. Yeah. If it fails, then it will create a RDO FTBSS.
Is there any gate in review OpenStack for RDO?
Yeah, so with all the OpenStack projects which find it critical, we have introduced RDO third-party jobs. So by using RDO third-party jobs, either you can build a package or early if you are not sure like this my change is going to break the RDO and other stuffs, so you can enable the third-party jobs or the experimental jobs. And with zuul v3, you can demand generate your own add your own jobs very easily by making the changes on zuul v3.
Okay.
Yeah.
Okay, thank you.
Yeah. Any more questions? Thank you.